Maternal Health Caucus.
Yeah, it's in response to some shocking statistics, ranking Indiana similar to countries like Iraq and Vietnam when it comes to the number of dying mothers.
Fox 59's Kayla Sullivan, she shows us the goals of this new caucus and also the ongoing efforts to work and make sure that our moms and babies are safe and healthy.
We have the third highest mortality rate in the nation.
State Representative Vanessa Summers says Indiana's maternal mortality rate is a crisis.
And we are going to work very hard from here on out to make sure that women are safe giving childbirth.
She's establishing a maternal health caucus to raise awareness, collect data, create a task force, and develop a state postpartum plan for mothers.
I'd like to develop some legislation and laws to address safe protocols. I would also like to deal with cultural competency in the hospitals. They don't believe African American women have pain. They don't think that we're sick.
It's a problem for every woman in our state, but particularly for black women.
In Indiana, about 41 white women die per every 100,000 births. For black women, that number is 53.
We need to not only be looking at the after effects, but let's start looking at making, for example, birth control more accessible. And I had a bill to address that sadly wasn't heard.
But a bill is moving its way through the Senate that would give pregnant women and new mothers more accommodations in the workplace. State Representative Rita Fleming says she supports it, despite opposition saying it may inspire more lawsuits and hardship on small companies.
These are very short-lived problems when you compare the longevity of a woman and her value in the workplace.
Anything that we haven't done up until this point is good. And there's a whole lot for women and pregnant women that we have not done in the state of Indiana.
Kayla Sullivan, Fox 59 News.
The pregnancy accommodations bill will be up for a second reading. That's on Monday. We'll let you know what happens from that.
All right, let's check in with Brian Wilkes now to talk about your weather authority.